In this video, we're going to use mesh current method to solve a problem where a current source has two mesh currents defined through it. And this will bring up a concept called supermesh. So we're going to start over on this side of the page. Both these circuits are identical, and you'll see why I'm going to show you two different solutions coming up here. But we're going to start over here, and you can see I already have the mesh currents defined, and I've put the polarity for the voltages across the resistors based on the directions for the mesh current that I picked. Now, in addition, we're going to define a voltage across this current source. And actually, I forgot to put in the value over here, but it's the same as what you see over at the left, that this is a 2-amp current source. But in addition, we're going to define a voltage across this current source with this polarity that we'll label VCS. Okay, so VCS is the voltage that's across this 2-amp current source. So now we're going to write a KVL equation, okay, for I1. And I'll start over here at the 30-volt source. So I'm going to have minus 30, then plus 1 times I1. Plus the voltage across the current source that I'm just going to write as the variable VCS. And then that sums to 0. Okay, so that's my KVL for I1. Now I'm going to do KVL for I2. Okay, and I'm going to start here at the current source. So going in the direction of I2, I'll have minus VCS. And then plus 2I2 plus 4I2, and that sums to 0. So from this expression here, I can write that VCS is equal to 2I2 plus 4I2, and I'm going to plug that into the top. So I would get this KVL equation for I1 now. Alright, so this just comes down here after I substitute in for VCS here, 2I2 plus 4I2. So now my KVL for I1 is going to be minus 30 plus I1 plus 2I2 plus 4I2. Equal to 0. Okay, so after I make the substitution for VCS, well, we have a KVL equation that has two unknowns, right? We have I1 and I2 here, so I'm stuck with one equation, two unknowns. So we've got to come up with a second equation that involves what we're solving for, which are the mesh currents. Well, this is where looking at the current source comes into play. Remember, this symbol, this current source symbol, tells me that there's 2 amps flowing in the direction of the arrow no matter what the voltage across that current source is. So I know that in this part of the circuit there's 2 amps flowing up. These mesh currents I defined, again, were just arbitrary. But since two mesh currents are defined through this current source, it means that these mesh currents have to equal this 2 amps. And since the mesh currents are defined going different directions through this current source, it means the difference of those two mesh currents has to be this 2 amps. So now the question is it I1 minus I2 is equal to 2 amps, or is it I2 minus I1 equals to 2 amps? Well, to determine which one it is, you look at, well, which mesh current is going with the arrow of the symbol, because that would be the positive one, and which mesh current is going against the arrow of the symbol, because that would be the minus one. So you see I2 is going with the arrow of the 2 amps, and I1 is going against the arrow of the 2 amps. So it's going to be that I2 minus I1 is equal to 2. And now you can go ahead and solve. You have two equations, two unknowns. Okay, well, this brings up something called a supermesh because you can solve this problem using supermesh concept. And a supermesh is when you have a current source with two mesh currents defined through it. So often in a book like RTEX, when there's a supermesh, you'll see a dotted ellipse around the current source. And what this means is that we can get the same answer as we got here with this solution by doing a KVL equation where we exclude the current source. Okay? So the supermesh would be considered this mesh here, okay, that involves all the elements except for the current source. So let's see how that works. So I'm going to write KVL, okay, for supermesh. Okay, so I'm going to start over here at the 30 volt source. I'll get minus 30. Okay, then here at the 1 ohm resistor, I'm going to get plus 1I1. Okay, now see, I continue on in the supermesh here. I'm not including the voltage across the current source in my KVL. So now I just come over here. This is going to be plus 2I2. Okay, and this here is going to be plus 4I2. And that sums to zero. So you see, I get the same expression as I did here once I made the substitution. See how this equation here is the same equation here. So it's similar to supernode and node voltage method, that supermesh is just a concept that can save you some work. See, it saved us a substitution here. Now you still need the second equation. You still need the I2 minus I1 equal to 2. Okay, but it just saves you some time getting this KVL equation here. Okay, so again, the reason I showed you, if you remember back in a previous lecture when I showed you supernode, I did the same sort of thing. I showed you two solutions right next to each other just to show you, what the concept was accomplishing. In both cases, supernode and supermesh, it just saves you some work. Okay, but you could solve a problem without even knowing supernode or supermesh concept. Okay? All right, but now if you go ahead and you solve for I1 and I2, you should get an answer of, let's see here, you should get an answer for I1. Okay, I1 comes out to, let's see, what does it come out to? It comes out to 2 and 4/7 amps. Okay, and I2 comes out to, okay, it's going to be two more than that, so it's 4 and 4/7 amps. All right, and just like always, you should be able to take these answers and go back to the circuit and find all the currents, all the voltages, and all the powers for the elements. Let's do one of those. Let's find the voltage. Given these answers here, let's find the voltage across the current source. So let's find the voltage across the 2 amp current source. Okay? Well, to get this voltage across the 2 amp current source, we can take any path between the two nodes that the current source is connected to and sum up those voltages, algebraically sum up those voltages to get what that voltage is. So in other words, we could just do a KVL equation either around this loop or a KVL equation around this loop, and that would give us the answer. So, for example, if I did a KVL around this loop, the voltage across the current source would equal 30 minus the voltage across that 1 ohm resistor. So 1 times I1, which is 2 and 4/7. So that would give us an answer of 27 and 3/7 volts. Okay, likewise, the voltage across the 2 amp current source would equal the two voltages across the 2 ohm and the 4 ohm resistor. So I could also get it from going 2 times I2. That's the voltage across the 2 ohm plus the voltage across the 4 ohm. So 4 times 4 and 4 sevenths. Okay, and that would add up to the same voltage, 27 and 3 sevenths volts. Okay, so, you know, I just decided to show you in this particular example to get the voltage across the current source, because sometimes that gives students some difficulty. You know, by now, to get the voltage across any of these resistors, right, shouldn't be a problem. You just take the current through it and multiply times the resistance, and that's your voltage resistor. You know, the current here for this voltage source is just going to be I1. And you can get power, again, just by V times I. But sometimes students forget, you know, that you can use KVL if you need to find voltage across an element in a loop like this. And using KVL to find voltage across a current source is often the way to go. Okay, we're going to do a few more problems in the next video involving SuperMesh.